Hey, you thieving bastards! Today we do hook swords. Swords, ancient Chinese weapon. Awesome for so many reasons. We're gonna go over some basics. Multi-edged weapon, dude, on the end, on the hilt. The edges, of course. Look at, you see that point? The hook and the point, that bulbous end, give it a weight. On the end, man, which really delivers a powerful whap, whap. And that point, dude, look at that point. That point is so fine. I mean, it goes in anything like butter. It goes right through the thick buffalo skin with the hair on, like butter. By the way, if you guys are wondering what that means in Japanese, it means holy oil, holy anointed oil. And it makes sense because this character that wears this, Jiraiya, he has a boiling oil jutsu. It's one of his. But back to the hook swords. So anyway, we're going to talk to, well, my son was the one that brought these up, dude. Alex, or Buzzkill as I like to call him. No, I'm just kidding. I joke. I kid. Hook swords, dude. They're awesome. Okay? Hooking the weapon, hooking the opponent, okay? Several advantages, okay? The bulbous heavy end and the, you know, allowing for the powerful whap. I mean, that penetrates pretty good, dude. And that curvature, you know, you can get that in pretty good. And this is all sharpened. If you notice, the whole thing isn't sharp. I'll show you why. But there's an edge right there. And there's an edge along here. This inside of the curve in here is not sharpened. And I'll show you why. But it's another advantage of this weapon. But you guys know how I feel being a big comma sickle side blade, hooked sword, weapons trapper kind of guy. I'm big into trapping weapons. And so this, you have a tremendous amount of reach to trap. And also, it's a decapitate, a decap trap, I like to call it. Because, dude, it's like a pair of scissors, man. This becomes giant, like basically like a giant pair of scissors. You know, or pruning shears, which I'm very well versed. Typical ninja, dude. I also want to give a shout. We're going to do this, by the way, in the straw sandals. Okay? Which, dude, they are so fucking tight. So fucking perfect. I'm telling you. Hook swords, dude. So, scissor motion, and trapping the weapon. For instance, we have a bow staff here. You can trap and control the bow staff. And it's, whereas with the other trapping weapons, you would have to typically dislodge one in order that you could strike. This, you don't have to because the edges are so, you could keeping the weapon trapped, you can strike. Oh yeah, this is also a sharpened edge. So, now, a couple of important motions for this weapon, which is one, one is figure eight, okay? First, you gotta get your wrists. You gotta get your wrists limbered up, okay? Because this is a necessary function, okay? And in doing figure eight, you pass over and then under, and then over, and then under. Does that make sense? Over, under. You just focus on one. Focus on the one in your right hand, if you're right-handed. Pass it over the other one, and then under. But doing full figure eight, okay? This being a figure eight, okay? Just same motion as this, but you're just moving it from side to side, okay? And you're working two at the same time without hitting them. So it works on your coordination. Plus, it would be very hard to advance on this without getting your body part or weapon trapped, okay? Of course, I'm very slow. I've only had these a couple of days, so I'm used to the shorter hooked weapons, comma sickles and side blades, and these are definitely heavier. I think I have a splinter. Oh, I do. Oh, crazy. No wonder that's hard. I have a splinter, dude. Trip out. Whoa. Dang, that's crazy. Look at that. It was like a little cactus splinter right in the webbing between my thumb and index finger. And I was like, dude, I was doing that. I'm like, damn, that fucking hurts, man. Crazy. That would have sucked. I'm like, wow, I can't get this splinter out. I just ruined this video. Look. So the most important move also is a hook. First of all, I've noticed you always want to slap them down. If you could get a rotation to build up momentum, and slap them, because either that point is going to go in and get a hook, or it's just going to grab the entire limb itself and get a hook. But you do more damage, you slap them and you pull it into a knee. Okay, that's your pull into the knee. Oof. Okay, another important technique is the over. Oh, yeah. Okay, so I'm always saying this one. This is how you train with every weapon, every two-handed weapon, is your right hand and your left hand over your right shoulder, right hip, and you switch it to your right hand over your left shoulder, your left hand over your left hip, okay? Or left shoulder, I mean. So don't hear my words, look at what's going on. I'll do it very slowly. So you're moving basically from hip to shoulder to opposite hip to shoulder. I'm showing it slowly because this, for some reason, took me a long time to get. It wasn't easy. Now I can't do it any other way. In fact, if I try, it just like morphs into this slowly, which is great. It's the greatest gift you could ever get, because any weapon you pick up, katanas, short ninjatas, two of anything, two kama sickles, two side blades, two daggers, two fucking hook swords. If you move in this motion and get that down, you could do what's called the chasing butterflies, which is one moving right after the other, dude, like they're chasing each other. And this is such an overwhelming thing to try to defend against, especially if you only have one weapon, like you have a bow staff or a katana, anything. You're going to become completely overwhelmed. You're going to have no choice but to block, which leaves you completely defenseless. And you don't want the enemy or your opponent to have any time to think. So one coming immediately behind the other is not just a tremendous or a good habit to have. It's necessary, man, because it's just a matter of, it's the right way. It's the only right way. And I've watched a lot of people on YouTube and a lot of people out in the real world, and nobody does it differently. Everybody uses this motion, from the stick fighter guy to everybody, man. You just see everybody, whether they know it or not, they're using this motion. So you have to master this motion. And then once you do, chasing butterflies is very easy, very fluid. 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2, 1-2. And it's hard to defend against also. And you could throw that whip in there. Okay? Okay, now, if you have any routines established, okay, and you want to work them in using the hook swords, it becomes difficult because they're long and cumbersome. And you have a lot of short moves in here that you, it just seems awkward when they're, so I find resting them in here also gives you some blocking capabilities, and you can whip it, which this has a tremendous edge on it, dude. It's 440 stainless, okay? So 440 stainless, all right? So it's really soft, and which means super sharp, but it's really easy to ding. Oh, you guys want to see the coolest trick, don't you? So here's the cool trick, dude. So you're in the habit of, okay, you rest them up here. Cool, huh? We're talking about maximum striking distance all the time. It's also why I like this, because you might try to establish or make your opponent think your maximum striking distance is in here, and they get comfortable getting close, and you could deliver a downward chop to, or, I mean, dude, just that alone is devastating. You're gonna be leaking from that, but you're also establishing maximum striking distance with this and keeping out of range of this. That's fine. All you do is throw a block and you've just doubled your maximum striking distance with a giant helicoptering razor blade. What, dude, what? Strike! Dude, this is my heart for giant helicopter blade, doubling maximum striking distance. Aww. Hook swords. Oh yeah, dude. So, you know, ancient Chinese weapon, unchanged for thousands of years, tremendously difficult to make, not nowadays, but typically. So there's no record whatsoever of, oh, here it is. There's no record whatsoever of hook swords, okay, in military use of any kind, okay? But it has been like kind of a standard Shaolin temple weapon, and very cool, very effective, and unchanged. In fact, the only variation I've ever seen is a spiked tip like that, dude, on the end of the hook. There's a small spike, you know? Which, dude, think about this for a second. Nobody takes care of wild animals. I was watching some crows, dude, when I got here a minute ago. And nobody takes care of those crows, dude. They're out here, dude. Them crows are out here in this jank, surviving, dude. Nobody takes care of them. They totally take care of themselves. Just rest assured, dude, that they're gonna go out and find what they need and get what they need. How awesome is that, dude? Huh? There's no crow feeding going on, dude. You know what I mean? There's no little crow church with little crow Jesus. Huh? None of that. Huh? Dude. Let's go get tattoos on our faces. Like, said no. That should, like, be on nobody's to-do list, dude, ever. Okay? Instead of getting a tattoo on your face, go make fucking straw sandals like this, dude. How rad is that? That the whole time we've been doing this in fucking straw sandals, dude. Look. Standard Japanese style with the Achilles protector. Dude, go look it up. The real way to wear these is having your toes hanging way off the front and this thing running way up the back of your Achilles. Like, ridiculous. But you know what? It is comfortable like that. I ain't gonna lie. So good, dude. And my Tommy Ching Chong hat, dude. Fuck, if you don't knock it off. Dude, what? Dude, I'm all about it. I'll tell you guys about betta fish, dude. You guys know betta fish? The dad does all the work. Yep. The mom only makes eggs. Hook swords, dude. Is that a coincidence? I don't know. Coolest fucking weapon ever, dude. I ain't gonna lie. It wasn't Captain Buzzkill's idea. It was, we got Mortal Kombat, dude, and we're playing it, and this guy has the hook swords, man, and then we started, like, working his routine a little bit, you know, like, whoa, no way, look, the Kama sickles, and then it was like, dude, I just looked it up, and like, of course, like, century martial arts. At a reasonable price. Dude, look. This has been a tremendous year for the ninja community. For real, dude. At first, I thought it was just going to be like the new ninja outfit. The new century martial arts ninja outfit. Like, with the slits in the leg, you know? At the top. has the sexy leg slits, you know, so there's a little bit of skin exposed right there. And it was like, oh, okay, wow, ooh, that's it. That and be water, right? Right? Again. Right? Hook swords. And I was cool with that. But no, then we got hit with the fucking Demon Slayer movie. Pa-pow! Did you notice, dude? I almost went the whole video without saying the F word. I don't know. We gotta look, dude. Hook swords. Yeah. No filters, no editing, no little crow Jesus sitting up in the tree. Dude. Oh, yeah. Oh, man. So check this out. Yeah. I found out why they have 10 doctors in a room when they're doing diagnosis. Because there's so many things. Like, I thought it was bacterial protozoa, and that might have been the case. But guess what? The vomiting and the baby shakes. Feline parvolonial virus, dude. And so, which is spread through poop, okay? Of all things, poop. So, here I'm thinking like, dude, oh, I was reading about it and like necessary quarantine and definite removal of the cat box. And it's like, dude, I come in there and they're licking each other's assholes and stuff. And it's like, what? Fuck, dude, that's it. It's done. It's shut down my whole operation. You know, I might have to get them all fixed and start over again with a vaccinated female. But it is what it is, dude. But bacterial protozoa, unless there's vomiting, dude. If there's vomiting, it's feline parvolonial virus. And that's definitely what causes the shaken baby and the arrested development of the nervous system in utero is the feline parvolonial virus. So, you know, this is kind of like cat AIDS. You know, some people call it cat leukemia. It's like, yay, we got cat AIDS. All right. No, but I found out, dude, while dealing with my cat AIDS, that female dogs are called bitches, and cats, female cats are called, does anyone know, dude? Anyone know? Bet you. Nobody knows. I'll bet you somebody knows, but guess what they're called? Queens. How fucking cool is that, dude? You know what I mean? Is that not the coolest? Or what? Hook swords! Yup. That's what's up, dude. Hook to a knee. Chasing butterflies. Figure eight. Trap weapon. Yeah. Oof. Flying razor. Hey. Go get you some hook swords, dude. Get your training on, dude. Bet you fall in love with ninjitsu. Stay golden. Showers.